Transgender Army Members Steph Sargent, Patricia King and Kept, Jennifer Peace discussed on The View Wednesday how the Trump administration's new transgender policy will change the lives of transgender people who currently serve their country and those who plan to join. Both King and Peace, who is also an intelligence officer with the Defense Intelligence Agency, are actively serving in the military. They received the Harvey Milk Foundation Valor Award at this year's Diversity Honors, where they met The View co-host Meghan McCain, Nicolette Kine, ABC, Sargent, Patricia King and Army Kept, Jennifer Peace talk about what's at stake for transgender troops. With Trump's new policy at The View on Wednesday, April 10, 2019. The new military transgender policy, instituted by the Pentagon on March 12, will go into effect on Friday, April 12. Under the new policy, transgender people currently serving the military will be allowed to continue serving so long as they follow the designated dress and grooming standards based on their birth gender. There's a possibility for systematic discrimination, King explained. The possibility that we will be evaluated differently when it comes time for a promotion or to go to a school. In terms of things like health care, our dependents, our children and our spouses, if they are transgender, they are at risk of receiving substandard care now. King continued, with the new military policy in place, transgender recruits will no longer be able to join the military if they underwent surgery or hormone treatment at any point in their lives. For anybody who's looking to join the military, if you're transgender, you're simply not welcome, King said. Peace, who began serving 15 years ago, compared the new transgender military policy to the don't ask, don't tell policy. You can be trans, you just can't come out, you can't transition, you can't tell anyone, you can't talk about it, but you can be trans, Peace said. The army captain went on to say that it's unfortunate to look back on the ban of black people serving in the military, when officials were considering lifting that ban, they said it's an unfortunate social distraction during a time of necessity. We said the same thing about women, gays and lesbians. We're going to look back on this in 10 or 15 years in the same way as baseless discrimination, Peace said. In July 2016, after consultation with generals and military experts, President Trump publicized his new military transgender ban in 3 tweets, his reason being that the military cannot be burdened with the tremendous medical costs and disruption that transgender in the military would entail. After consultation with my generals and military experts, please be advised that the United States government will not accept or allow Donald J. Trump at real Donald Trump. July 26, 2017, transgender individuals to serve in any capacity in the U.S. military. Our military must be focused on decision overwhelming. Donald J. Trump at real Donald Trump, July 26, 2017, Victorian cannot be burdened with the tremendous medical costs and disruption that transgender in the military would entail. Thank you, Donald J. Trump at real Donald Trump. July 26, 2017, King, who has been serving for nearly 20 years, was the first person to have the military finance the cost of her reassignment surgery, but claimed it was a difficult process with a lot of red tape. Nicolette Kine, ABC, Sergeant Patricia King and Army Kept, Jennifer Peace talk about what's at stake for transgender troops with Trump's new policy at The View with co-hosts Joy Behar, Abby Huntsman, Anna Navarro, Sunny Hostin, and Meghan McCain on Wednesday, April 10, 2019. For King, joining the military wasn't for the purpose of obtaining transgender health care. If my concern was to have transgender medical care, I would go and look at working at a place like Starbucks, King said. I wouldn't have to worry about deploying the stigma and red tape to have medically necessary care. In February, Kingen Peace testified before Congress against the Trump administration's transgender service policy, becoming the first ever active transgender service members to do so. Every episode of a BAFTA award-winning talk show, The View, is now available as a podcast. Listen and subscribe for free on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, TuneIn, Spotify, Stitcher or the ABC News app.